Another reason for the inspiration of this feed was finding a customer showing me a pen in Boston that was used to be a vacuumatic major in green. They altered it severely. The threading here was altered a great deal so that it would unscrew with ease, the normally tight threads. The filler mechanism was removed, and this was glued shut and polished off as if it were one single piece. This, in essence, well, it wasn't reversible. And they spent something like $60 to have it done. Here is a diagram of this feed. Now remember, the whole unit costs about cost of a bottle of Noodler's ink. This is the feed. Here's the unaltered feed as you'll find it in the pen. And here is an altered feed. Now, the only thing I did here, I cut an L tube that was wide enough for a breather tube to be set next to the center rollerball feed, like so. And provided the inner diameter is the same as the outer diameter of the feed, you're in business, and this can be put in numerous vintage pens. It can be used in a lever filler. If you don't want to wear the nib away, this turquoise Lady Patricia, it's completely unaltered. It's still the sack filling pen. You haven't done anything to the original pen, and it's now writing as a rollerball, refillable with Noodler's inks, any ink from a bottle. And over again, you can refill it without ever throwing away a disposable unit into the landfill. Here's a Goldfill Schaefer lever filler from the early 1920s. Here's a Skyline. Of course, this would need a breather tube. The sack's a bit small. But there it is. No alteration. You can pull this out. You put back the nib and the feed, and you've got your original pen. Here's a Black Parker Vacuumatic. It should also be noted that other Noodler's pens, here are two Ebonite Noodler's pens, you can place this feed in. Sometimes it will require some heat to get this diameter. Now, given that this is all ebonite, it will require a little bit of heat to soften it for fitting. Now, these breather tubes I have, they're friction fit. The reason it's friction fit is so that you can remove it later and still use it in your piston filler. There's nothing permanent about it, but it'll hold up, and you can then use this as an aerometric. Here you have a ripple ebonite aerometric rollerball. If there's demand for these from retailers, we'll simply issue them like this, but that's up to you, the viewer. The Parker Vacuumatic, put this in more firmly. I will demonstrate here. I would like you to note that the air vent spiral, when you put this in a Parker Vacuumatic, is extended. Now, ebonite can be carved with a knife, a packing knife, an X-Acto, anything like that. You're simply putting a groove that goes from the spiral to where the section will end, wherever you happen to want to set it. This is vital. You want the ink to flow through that tube. It's not going to flow through the roller ball very easily. This is a tight tolerance. You have to have the air-ink interchange go through with ease. And you do that by extending that breather hole. This is very weak colored water inspired by a competitor's ink. Now this is a rollerball tip. Now, you might not be able to see it, but this vac is filled up to about there. And now one would just wipe it off, wick out the inside of the section. This is very important with all stylos, and this is still in essence a stylographic pen. And you have your vacuumatic roller without having done any damage to the original pen. Now, here's another example. This one, hopefully, will be more clear. This is a version of a vacuumatic called a diamond metal vac fill. You see, it has the classic old metal filler unit. See where the bubbles are? Right there. It's full. Now you can fill, as a result, vacuumatics. You can fill lever fillers. You can fill any piston filler with a like kind diameter that doesn't require an offset. Here, this is an Eagle celluloid from the 1930s. Small bulb filler, right diameter. Had a fatter breather tube for this model. There's the air vent from the L shape that's within the spiral of the feed. It's a nice tight fit. You have to wait for the sac to draw up. This is a relatively old sac. I restored this pen, I think, in the early 1990s. Probably needs a new sac. And there. It's full. This is a bulb filling stylo that writes with a rollerball tip. Colored blue water, not an ink. This is an ever sharp, it's almost like an equipoise. It's an ever sharp junior. These are those tricky ones that the barrel will unscrew from the clear part of a unitary section. They do require a breather tube. The sack is rather small, is only about this big, way in the back. They hold a decent amount of ink and they look nice. Let's see how this goes. There you have it. Yet another vintage pen that can be filled and used with multiple inks as a rollerball. So this equipoise type Eversharp, this Leverfill Schaefer, Leverfill Waterman Patricia, Leverfill Skyline, another Leverfill Schaefer, Vacuumatic, Bulb Filler. It's virtually limitless. So the next time somebody offers to restore your vintage pen and create a pen that can only use a roller ball, a disposable roller ball that you throw away after its single use, and that the manufacturer limits you to a handful of ink colors, remember that you can buy one of these little nib creepers from Noodler's Ink, and you can utilize this ebonite feed that's in this pen by installing this breather tube, or in the case of a lever filler like these, you don't have to do anything. You just need to find one that has the same diameter. Even then, if you're skilled enough, you can put a sleeve to enable it to go into larger pens. But this feed was made in great part with you in mind, and those who are unfamiliar with stylographic fountain pens, perhaps to introduce the wondrous world of stylos, which I've been collecting all my life, to them, and that it's affordable and practical. If the tip gets completely wrecked or miserably clogged after a vacation, or you put divergent inks in it and it gets clogged, that's yet another reason to have something that's replaceable with a 25-cent tip. These pens also write extraordinarily well with Bay State Blue. Some of you have asked for a pen that can be dedicated to Bay State Blue. This one, it's a perfect example. It was made with parts from all over the world. The Indian subcontinent, Boston, Massachusetts, help from, and parts of the package, Maryland, California. This micro-printed metal top is also Boston. And the tip is made in Switzerland. So yes, it's an international pen, and it wouldn't be possible without free trade. And again, just the cost of an ink bottle with a 25-cent tip. That's all. Hope this film is of use to you.